and welcome back. I am Cindy von Willig and this is my little piece of the internet. Thank you for joining me. In September of every year, Water Faith Christian Center has a women's conference called Arise Women's Conference. Now, with COVID and everything going digital, of course, so did the Arise Women's Conference. I will leave some links in the description below and you can see what the Arise Women's Conference is all about. In today's video, I will share with you the time that I spent in the kitchen with Chef Sandhir Uri. Now, Chef Sandhir Uri is the resident chef at Word of Faith Christian Center. He runs Connection Cafe, and I tell you, they make the best pizza. While I'm here, I want to say thank you to Arise for allowing me to use this insert. I also want to say thank you to Adhoc Productions for the filming of the insert. Here we go. Get your cooking mitts on and let's make some lovely chicken and muffins. Enjoy the video. Today we are in the kitchen with Chef Sandhir Uri, the resident chef at Connection Cafe here at Word of Faith. What are we making today?
Thank you, Cindy, and welcome everyone to my kitchen. We're just making a cheddar cheese and baby marrow savory muffin today.
So let's go. What do we need?
Okay, just a few simple ingredients we have for this specific recipe. It's a practically 8 to 10 minute prep time and another 20-25 minutes baking time. On my left here, if you see, we've got the 8 ingredients that goes into this dish. We have some grated baby marrow, grated cheddar cheese. We have cake flour, baking powder, touch of cayenne pepper for a bit of spice, eggs, mixed herbs, and milk. And those are the ingredients that goes into the specific dish. So, all right, we have our mixing bowl, dry ingredients, 1 cup of flour, 2 teaspoons of baking powder, 1 teaspoon of mixed herbs, and those are our dry ingredients. On the side, we got our wet ingredients, which is the milk and the eggs, 2 eggs.
I wish I could do it that way.
A cup of milk. And this we beat together so that when we put it into the dry mixture, it's blended and it gives you an even bake.
Is there anything you would like me to do, Chef, while you are mixing up?
You can add the baby marrows into the dry mixture.
Baby marrows.
Yes. There we go. That's 2 grated baby marrows in there. 2 teaspoons of baking powder went into there, 1 cup of flour and 1 teaspoon of mixed herbs. Thank you, Cindy. And we have 1 cup of grated cheese that's going in there into the same mixture.
There we go.
There we go. You want to, with a wooden spoon, we're going to give that a mix. Do you want to mix that? Wooden
spoon. No, I think I should let Chef do that.
Every
kitchen
should have this. Obviously, back in there, this was a weapon of mass destruction as well at home,
yes.
Used by our parents. All right, and then we add our wet ingredients, which is the 2 eggs and 1 cup of milk, and the egg mixture into the dry ingredients, and we give that a good mix together, where it all blends in and mixes properly, because you want an even, you want all your muffins to basically be even.
Chef, how many muffins do we get out of this mixture?
With a standard muffin, you should get anything between 10 and 12.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to go for a 60 gram muffin, which is a bit bigger, you're going to go with 8, or a jumbo muffin, which is 6. So it all depends what size pans you have. There's many different sizes, but your standard pan should give you at least 12 muffins. And that's it. That's our mixture done.
Looking good.
Now we're going to put it into a pan and we're going to bake at 180 degrees for 20 to 25 minutes. I've already spread it, but yes, you have to use, otherwise your muffins are not going to come out of this pan and you're going to have to use a teaspoon to eat them out of the pan. So here we go. Just like that. It's a quite runny mixture, so you got to be quick with it if you can, so you don't mess up the pan too much.
Awesome.
All right, here we go. We've got 12 muffins out of this pan. And this is going to go into the oven and bake at 180 degrees for 20 to 25 minutes.
And now for our second meal of the day. Chef?
Second meal for the day, we're preparing a chicken, honey and soy with garlic. It's quite an easy dish to make. It's simple, the ingredients are quite simple. And it's very quick to make. Preparation time from start to end, 10 to 15 minutes. If you're looking for a healthy meal,
yeah,
this is the full meal.
It being locked down, I think we need to have healthier options.
Well,
hey?
Not all of us.
Let's get going.
Okay,
what
this
have we got?
Dish, we have chicken filleted breasts. Preferably about a 200 gram portion, which is a standard protein portion per person on a meal plate. Then we have the ingredients that we use for the chicken. We've got garlic, we've got butter, flour, pepper, salt, honey, soy sauce, and those are the only ingredients that go into the chicken.
So that's the normal soy sauce?
That's a light soy sauce. Yes, it's a light soy sauce. You get light, dark and thick. Preferably the light because you don't want a strong flavor to overpower the garlic and the honey. You want it to balance out.
Yeah, because if you are anything like I am, I need to know specifically what we need.
Well, 2 tablespoons of soy sauce, 2 tablespoons of honey, just a pinch of salt and pepper, about 80 grams flour, which we're going to dust the chicken in, 3 tablespoons of butter and 1 tablespoon of crushed garlic. And that's all the ingredients that goes in here.
Awesome. And this will serve how many
this
people?
This meal will serve four portions.
Excellent. Okay. Let's go.
Right. Chicken breast fillets. We're just going to trim that. And obviously the chicken breast will be wanting to cook quick. I'd suggest that we cut each steaklet lengthwise down. And that's fillet we have there.
That's a sharp knife, eh? Hey?
Yes, it is. We have to have sharp knives. We don't want to fight and tear the chicken. So having a good sharp knife is definitely
important.
Very important.
Okay.
And when you get cut with a sharp knife, it's less painful.
Oh, rather you than me. Rather you than me, Chef. I would not want to be cut with any sort of knife.
All right, so now we're going to dust the chicken into the flour. Yes,
can I pass you some flour in the bowl?
In the bowl, thank you. And let's put a touch of salt and pepper in here. Salt, pepper. There we go. Okay, and then we give that a quick stir.
There we go.
Just mix that up.
Don't you just love all these little bowls? I love watching cooking shows and you've always got these cute little sectioned out ingredients in your beautiful little bowls. Wow, it's beautiful.
It's easier for reference and to use and visualize as well, and you can see exactly what it is.
Yes.
So yeah, they are quite nice. Okay, now we're gonna just lightly dust our chicken in the flour and salt and pepper mixture.
Mm-hmm.
So we're gonna use a skillet. If you don't have a skillet, a normal, preferably a non-stick pan will be much easier to work with.
Okay, so the couscous you've decided is just to help us to have an idea of how we can serve this meal, this dish as a meal.
Well, we have 80 grams of couscous in here, and this is half a cup of water, that boiling water that we're going to put in there. Touch of olive oil so that it doesn't stick. It's nice and loose when you want to work with it. And I think for some flavor, we're going to add a touch of cumin powder. And we just set that aside until we're ready to use it. You'll actually see what happens in there right now. It'll work itself and it'll form into a nice, like a crumbly dish that we would serve on the side with our chicken. All right, after coating our chicken lightly in flour, we're now going to grill it. We need 2 tablespoons of butter in the pan. Make sure your pan's nice and hot.
So I would normally use oil, Chef.
Well,
I see you're using butter.
Yeah, we use butter to give the chicken a nice flavor. At the same time, it keeps the chicken nice and tender. And to prevent the butter from burning, we're going to add a bit of olive oil. Just a touch.
That's very interesting.
All right, as you can see, our butter's melted, the pan's nice and hot, the butter is turning a bit brown, it's ready for the chicken to go in. We're gonna grill each fillet, well, basically together in the pan, 3 minutes. And then we turn over.
So we've just put some flour, salt and pepper on this chicken. Chef, why did we use flour?
Flour gives you a nice crispy coat.
Mm-hmm.
And at the same time, with the honey, soy and garlic sauce that's going into it, it helps absorb the flavors and sticks to the chicken. So your flavor is on the chicken and it absorbs it into the chicken.
And
as
that's
well.
What the flour
that's
does.
Right. For at least 2 to 3 minutes, we're going to turn and then we're going to add the rest of our ingredients into the same pan. So all the flavors are there. Pretty nice.
That's looking good.
There we go. We just want to caramelize it a little bit to give it that crispy coating on the outside.
That's looking really good. I wish that you were here to smell this. The smell of the butter melting
golden
is just amazing. Brown.
There we go. As you can see that looks very nice.
Okay, what do we do?
All right, next we're going to start adding our ingredients to make the sauce. Do you want to pass me the garlic? Tablespoon of crushed garlic into the pan. And we're just going to swirl that around a bit.
Mmm.
Can you smell that? All right, next we go with the light soy sauce.
Light soy sauce.
Thank you. All right, next we're going to go with the apple cider vinegar, which is 2 tablespoons of apple cider vinegar.
Apple cider vinegar.
This is just to give it a bit of a tang. That can go all around. And last but not least goes in the honey. 2 tablespoons of honey.
Here we are.
Thank you. This we can just put around in the dish.
I cannot wait to taste this.
Yes.
Fortunately, I can taste this.
Can you smell those flavors coming out? Yeah?
I smell it. It's amazing.
Now we just drop the temperature a little bit so it can cook on low for another 2 to 3 minutes.
Pretty easy. Very, very
simple,
easy.
Very quick.
Very simple.
You come home from work, your chicken breasts are defrosted. Quick. 15 minutes, you can have supper ready. Can you see that sauce that's caramelizing in the pan? That's what you want. That's the effect you want of this dish.
It's now 5 minutes later. That was very easy. Now we're moving on to plating. Chef, how
right,
do we plate?
Plating, as I mentioned earlier, we put in some couscous to get ready for our main dish. This is what it looks like. There's olive oil in here and some cumin powder.
And we've done nothing else to it.
Absolutely nothing.
It's just
look at it. And a
perfect.
Touch of olive oil. Just to give it some flavor, I've grilled some peppers and red onion, which you can just add to, just to make it colorful as well. We just give that a light mix. Add a little bit to our plate. There we go. That's our chicken. It's nicely coated. As you can see, the color and the sauce is nice and thick. We're going to place that there. And I've also prepared some vegetables just to make the plate more healthy and more interesting, which I'm just going to add to the pan that the chicken came out. The vegetables has been pre-cooked lightly, so I'm just going to flavor it with the sauce that's in the pan.
Wow, isn't that a good idea? We are using the flavors
of the
of
chicken
the
which is your honey, soy sauce and garlic.
Not to mention how beautiful it looks when it comes out of the glistening oil.
Here we go. Alright, then I think we're just going to drizzle some of the sauce around our plate. Here we go.
And there we have it.
Rosemary and a little cherry tomato. And we have our dish that's ready.
Thank you so much. I love that you can do this at home quickly with no fancy ingredients. Anyone can do it. Let's move on to our muffin mix. So chef, the muffins are out of the oven.
Yes.
Let's plate them.
All right. We just have a little side plate here. We got some strawberry jam and we got some grated cheese to go with that. Just for presentation, these are what the muffins look like on a plate. Simple, strawberry cut in half, just to give it some color. And there we go.
And there you have it, ladies. Easy as pie.